Good evening, everyone. At this time, the class of 2023 will enter the stadium. Please help us keep that front aisle clear for the processional. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening once again, and welcome. What a beautiful evening to recognize and celebrate our graduates. Please stay standing for our Star Spangled Banner. Graduates, leave your caps on for this formal ceremony. You may be seated. I would now invite our Student Council President, Grace Collis, to the podium.
Good evening, and welcome to the Class of 2023 Commencement Ceremony. Congratulations to all the students for their hard work and achievements. To the families and friends here today, thank you for coming, and we are so happy to have you. A special thanks goes out to all the parents, families, and friends of the graduates for their continued support throughout the years. Thank you for sharing in our celebration of our time at Clear Creek Amana High School.
Thank you, Grace. And now we will hear a piece that has been pre-recorded by our very own Cantores Choir. At this time, I would like to welcome our Student Council Vice President, Emma Descaray, for the introduction of our guests.
Attending this ceremony tonight, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the members of the Clear Creek Amana School Board, President Kara Prickett, Vice President Joe Burns, Board Members Jennifer Downs, Sean Kukuski, Matt McAravy, Jennifer Mooney, Eileen Schmidt, and Superintendent Dr. Corey Seymour. Thank you.
Thank you, Emma. And now I'd like to invite Matthew Wu and Emily Bernacki for the senior reflections.
Good evening, everybody. I'll be honest with you. I wasn't planning on standing up here today. It brings me little joy to stand in front of a crowd because they think I'm smart. Except the day before the drafts of the speeches were due, Mr. Holter and Mr. Hutch. I'll be honest, I don't remember which one, but if you want recognition, you're feel free to stand up and mark that for you. They came into Ms. Okopsky's room. And on seeing me, they asked me if I was planning on writing a speech, because none of the valedictorians had expressed interest yet. And so, over the course of 3 hours in the library, watching 9th and 10th graders mess around, I wrote a speech. And it went something like this. I can prove that I am conscious, because I believe that I am. I, however, cannot prove that the rest of you are conscious as well. For all I know, you might as well just be well-programmed robots made by God to stimulate me, an experiment by God to determine if free-thinking beings are actually a good idea. That last part about the robots came from a book, The Breakfast of Champions, that Ms. Okopsky suggested that I read earlier this year. Thank you, Ms. Okopsky. At the end of the speech, I point out how depressing the world would be if everyone else was just a robot. And so we should choose to believe that we're all real human beings. We're the conscious, feeling human beings. And since we're real conscious, feeling human beings and not robots, we should treat everybody with respect and kindness and be nice to them no matter what. And so if you need a moral to take away from today, the most significant thing you can be in this life is to be kind. And I submitted that speech 10 minutes before it was due. This is not that speech. This is the speech I wrote yesterday and today and finished at 3 o'clock. I apologize, Mr. Reisinger. I made a new friend this year, someone who in years past I would never have been friends with, a certain Mr. Lance Johnson. And in order to avoid stroking his ego too much, I'll leave my description of him at saying that talking to him for 3 classes each semester was, interesting. And in those same minutes before the speech deadline, Lance also happened to be trying to submit his speech. And his internet cut out. I say all of this to point out that if my internet had died in those same few minutes, that I wouldn't be standing up here either. Maybe now I should make some point about not taking things for granted, about the small things in life, about living in the moment. Maybe about some grand epiphany about life or a high school experience. But in truth, that's not what this speech is about. Although it's also not what the speech is about. So I'll read to you some of what Lance wrote in his speech because, you know, Lance, he says it better than I do. All right, Lance said, it's funny how time works. When you're 5, you want to be 10 so you're double digits age. And then you want to be 13 so you're considered a teenager. And you want to be 16 so you get your license and have freedom on the road. And then you want to be 18 so you can make your own decisions. Well, now all you want to do is go in reverse. Suddenly, you realize that your time is up and your childhood is over now. But all we can do is look forward, excite ourselves for what is to come, and realize that school ending marks the beginning of greater things coming your way. This speech, though, is about expectation and contemplation. I struggled to write it because I felt a need to make a point, to have some genuine reason that you all would want to listen to me. I have no universal theme for you today. I cannot tell you that being kind to everybody leads to a better life because I promise you I'm not kind enough to say that. I cannot tell you to not take things for granted because I definitely take things for granted all the time. I would tell you all my most meaningful experiences that I'd missed from high school, but maybe 40 of you would relate. So I'll ask you to determine some ultimate moral for yourself. And I'll ask you to think back to everything that has shaped you these last 4 years. Freshman year, we had expectations about what high school would be like, and I think it's safe to say that we're all wrong. We had expectations placed on us, finding friends, maintaining grades, getting a significant other. We've been expected to get projects done, staying up late the night that it's due. We've expected, hoped our teammates would do their share. There have been beauty standards and social pressures telling us to get our driver's license and a job. We have an expectation to do something with ourselves after we graduate. I ask you to determine for yourself if these expectations are good. Expectation made me stand up here today. And I wonder if the fact that the people expected me to speak scared them away from also coming up here themselves. And I assume that Hutch Halter expected me to speak. And I wonder if all of you expected me to speak as well. It was my parents' expectation that I took school seriously. They gave me my 4.0. I still wonder if this expectation was good. It worsened my relationship with them. You miss out on things because of it. People judge you. At the end of the day, people will still remember me as a smart kid, and I suppose I am. But I don't want to be smart. I want to be kind. My parents also expected me to be kind. So I ask you again if you think expectations are good. I ask you to think about your own life and your own experiences, especially that Matthew is not always right. The thought arose in my mind that I wonder if this speech lived up to your expectations. But please don't come to me afterwards and tell me what you thought about it unless you want to have an actual conversation. Because y'all are amazing, but there's too many of you and I don't need the next 2-3 days of my life being people telling me I did a good job. So I should start by thanking people, and all of the people who wave or say hi to me in the hallways, you are some of the best people at spreading joy and happiness that I know. You make me want to show up at school every day. I'll miss you. And to my parents, teachers, and friends, you are the people who have made me who I am today. It was your expectations, feedback, and conversations that shaped me. I thank you. And I would like to give a special thanks to the janitors, grounds, and buildings maintenance crew. You do so much work for so little things. It took me too many years to realize how beautiful our campus is, especially the trees lining the front of our beautiful high school. And to the administrators, whose job I'm surely is infinitely more complex than I'm giving them credit for, I thank you a lot. And to the random people who somehow know my name without me knowing theirs, I wish I could have gotten to know you better. And I thank you for making me feel really weird when you start talking to me. And lastly, to the senior class, the last few years have been the adventure of a lifetime, the best years of our life. Sometimes I wonder if an alternate reality, where there is a different graduating class, if it somehow would have been better. And the logical side of me says that every grade has its people, the nerds, the jocks, the artists, the party people, and the more reserved. And I tell myself that in reality, it should all average out, that each grade should be about the same. But somehow I don't believe it. And no offense to the other classes, but this is the greatest senior class ever. And I could never ask for a better one. And my time here with you has been a pleasure, and I will miss it. Once again, thank you very much.
Thank you, Matthew. And now, Emily Bernacki.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for being here. It is quite an honor to be part of the 2023 commencement ceremony tonight and be speaking on behalf of all other valedictorians. Today, we all gather here for the same reason, to celebrate the 13 long, hard, and exhausting years we've all put in. All but one, the class of 2023 isn't the same without one of our dearest friends, Noah Herring. We miss the smiles he never failed to share with us. I'd also like to share more heartfelt condolences with those who are missing friends and family this evening. We carry you in our hearts as we walk across the stage tonight. But now that our years on the fields, courts, and stage are over, parents, grandparents, friends, how do we feel? Are we crying yet? Or maybe a sigh of relief? I would bet Mrs. Schloss and Miss Okopski are shedding a few tears. I hope you have all taken many, many pictures to look back and remember the good old days. But now what? We're done. Anyone remember a single thing from chemistry or history? Yeah, I figured. Although our years of high school were quite an experience, try not to dwell on the details of a chem exam that didn't quite go your way, or a final paper that may have been better. Don't forget things like pounds on pounds on pounds of baby powder on Friday nights, endless laughter at the lunch tables, award-winning performances, or friendships that may last a lifetime, and even the wise words to live by from our teachers. Mr. Halter gave my composition class a bit of advice a while ago, and I think everybody needs to hear it. He says, if you're in a relationship right now, go ahead and break up real quick. If you miss them 6 months into college, you might have something. So do with that as you will. As we all gather our belongings and embark on our own journeys, parting ways and making new friends, I strongly encourage everyone to not lose sight. Be genuine, be honest, be kind, work hard, and simply show up. Think about why you're doing what you're doing when you may be holding on by a thread or oh so close to giving up. Greatness is never too far out of reach for any of us. The future is ours, and we have to give thanks to those who have supported us. Thank you, teachers, for taking way more attitude than you get paid for. Thank you to the faculty and janitorial staff for always creating such an uplifting and clean environment. Thank you, family and friends, for encouraging excellence for every one of us, all the way from listening to us read for 20 minutes throughout elementary school to maybe staying up late studying for a big history test with us. I hated that, and I know you did too. Thank you to everyone who ever doubted us. It just made us work a little harder. A final thank you to the Clear Creek Amana community for supporting athletics, the fine arts, and more. You have made it so memorable for all of us. I wish you luck on your future and know that there will always be someone in your corner cheering you on. Good luck to those who may be serving our country. Good luck to those who are going to save lives. Good luck to those who will be building houses, cars, bridges, roads. Good luck to those who hope to expand their leadership, better their attitude, and deepen their faith. Good luck with whatever you aspire to be. I'd like to end with a quote by Carrie Mars. She says, observe without judgment. Notice that all thoughts and feelings come and go. Recognize that you are not your thoughts and feelings. You are experiencing them. You are the captain of the ship, and those thoughts and feelings are what you are navigating. Thank you.
Thank you, Emily. And now I would invite Assistant Principal Mike Potter to the stage to present the class of 2023.
Jeffrin Acevedo. Jaden Adamson. Owen Aldrich. Avery Allen. Caleb Allen. Shane Anderson. Rachel Astorino. Hope Austin. Shauna Bailey. Lydia Bacopoulos. Braden Ballard. Hayden Barker. Caden Baxter. Lucia Becadas Rodriguez. Claire Bites. Emily Bernacki. Connor Bondi. Gabe Borman. Melina Bowman. Momin Bushra. Dakota Cantrell. Dawson Cantrell. Max Carlson. Gwen Chuen. Sandra Collentine. Grace Collis. Jack Colvin. Mason Consemius. Ruby Crosby. Hayden Crow. Joseph Curtin. Joshua Curtis. William Danes. Amy Dale. Emma Descaray. Jack Downs. Samantha Drake. Dumalushle Dube. Thomas Dunn. Ethan Echternacht. Abigail Eckrich. Liam Engel. Leah Evans. Gracie Fillers. Nash Fisher. Riley Fox. Harkaron Gill. Jacob Gorsch. Brady Graft. Lexi Hackman. Catherine Hennis. Noah Herring. Dallas Hill. Reese Hoffman. Gage Holmes. Chase Horning. Connor Hosford. Ryan Humphrey. Morgan Jarrell. Sophia Jaspering. Caitlin J. Cash Jensen. Lance Johnson. Johnson. Logan Johnson. Nicholas Johnson. Blessing Cabaselli. Silvana Caballo. Prisca Kalala. Tara Kent. Devin Kick. Cameron Kim. Lara Conkel. Claire Kratz. Chloe Cruzy. Ahmed Ibrahim Kunate. Weston Kuntz. Marcus Lang. Worky Larry. Ethan Lee. Aaliyah LeGrand. Anna Lodi. Joshua Lauren. Xavier Lyman. Mary McCumber. Elijah Malicote. Damian Manzo. Melanie Matrice. Eston McAlpin. Zachary McCarty. Olivia Miller. Sky Mitchell. Cassidy Montross. Tristan Morris. Isabel Morrow. Marlena Mueller. Brianna Myers. Denise Wynn. Aurora Norpel. Jemima Simba. Caleb Otto. Moritz Parman. Lauren Passbrig. Hunter Pierce. Kiara Petardi. Itali Ramirez. Audrey Rice. Andy Rios. Colby Ripperton. Asaya Roby. Asher Raylor. Anna Rojas Afanador. Kyler Ronfelt. Jarrell Rush. Jessica Sather. Andrew Schlemmy. Jackson Schloss. Jackson Schmidt. Samuel Schneider. Laney Schroeder. Aiden Schropp. Vincent Scoville. Brock Sherman. Jaden Seward. Cameron Sigworth. Brody Smith. Owen Smith. Mitchell Smica. Okoko Sosu. Peyton Stadler. Natalie Stewart. Andrew Streit. William Swift. Callie Thomas. Grant Trimpe. Dante Umorin. Johanna Unterberger. Jake Van Handel. Kyler Weiss. Natalie Wade. Jessica Wagner. Andon Waterbury. Charlotte Watson. Caitlin Watson. Corbin Weber. Brenner Worley. Maxwell Whitehead. David Williams. Matthew Wu. Tyler Wolfcool. Gracie Yoder. Kyra Zimmerman. Davina Magdalena Zudel.
I would be remiss if I didn't go off script here for just a minute. In addition to our graduates, there's one additional person that deserves to be acknowledged. After 22 years, Mr. Potter has decided to pursue other professional options. During his time at CCA, Mr. Potter has worn many hats. A few examples would be teacher, coach, assistant principal, mentor, advisor, friend, disciplinarian, counselor, cheerleader, Royal Clipper. Please join me for a round of applause. And he may never speak to me again. Class of 2023, please stand up again. I'm sorry. To signify your transition from student to graduate, please move your tassel from the right to the left side of your graduation cap. And now, it is my honor to present to you the community of Clear Creek Amana High School, the graduating class of 2023. Congratulations. To stay in the stands and as our graduates exit. Thank you for joining us this evening.